Hello everyone. I have synthesized an interesting substance called DPPE-1. It is a primary explosive, meaning it can detonate from a simple ignition or impact. And it shows considerable promise as a potential replacement for lead azide. Here its formula, unlike lead azide, it doesn't contain heavy metals or toxic organic components. It's made from simple non-explosive precursors, though they aren't readily available outside of a laboratory setting. The synthesis itself is quite straightforward. You simply mix aqueous solutions of the corresponding salts and DPPE-1 precipitates out. This substance exhibits excellent stability to moisture, air and sunlight. It also has rather good thermal stability, beginning to decompose above 160 degrees, which satisfies most military and civilian requirements. While not unique, other amine peridides with similar properties exist, as do other perovskite explosives based on DAPCO amine. DPPE-1 stands out due to a rather unique property. It can stably initiate RDX in quantities around 10 mg. Article even mentioned quantities as low as 5 mg, which places it among the most powerful primary explosives like lead azide and silver azide. Unfortunately, DPPE-1 still can't be an ideal substitute for lead azide, because its decomposition temperature is below 200 degrees. Lead azide is generally very difficult to replace due to its unique combination of higher power, higher stability and ease of synthesis. While very powerful tetrazole compounds exist, their complex synthesis makes them unlikely to replace lead azide. I synthesized this compound and conducted some sensitivity tests. For comparison, I used another very powerful explosive, nickel aminoguanidine perchlorate, NAP, which I also really like. Both substances can detonate in quantities of few tens of milligrams. NAP is noticeably less sensitive than lead azide. I would say that DPPE-1 is very similar to NAP in terms of impact sensitivity, detonating under approximately the same conditions. Regarding friction sensitivity, I personally found DPPE-1 to be slightly more sensitive than NAP. Overall, I am quite pleased with this substance. It would be great to further test its initiating capability and confirm if 10 mg is truly sufficient to initiate RDX. However, my channel isn't about explosives, so I won't be doing that. That's all I wanted to share today. You can find more information about this compound in the original article. The link will be in the description. Goodbye.